Joining me now to discuss Family Zone is Tim Levy. Tim, thanks very much for coming in today.
Thanks, Danielle. Thanks for having me.
So it's a bit of an interesting, different company. Can you introduce us, please, to Family Zone?
Yeah, so Family Zone, we're a cyber safety company, which is in contrast with an internet security business, which is about protecting assets and information. Cybersecurity is really about protecting users. And you know, in the home example, it's about keeping your kids safe in the internet when they access the internet or use gaming devices and so on. And in schools, it's about managing duty of care, schools' obligations to keep kids safe, and with having attention in class. And there's a number of businesses out there doing this sort of thing in these different verticals, in telcos, in schools, in consumer. But what we do that's truly unique, we call it the ecosystem. And it comes from us being telco guys. So the group of the Family Zone founders all have telecommunications experience. I'm a retail mobile phone guy in Australia. We've got telco tech guys. And what our approach is this. We think about cyber safety like an international roaming business. Imagine if you're, when you get off the phone, get off the plane in Heathrow, you turn on your phone and the GSM networks know who you are. They know your mobile number, what services are available to you, that sort of thing. And that's the concept of Family Zone. Anywhere that you go on the mobile networks, GSM knows who you are. And wouldn't it be great as a parent that if you knew that anywhere your child goes, the policies, the rules that you've chosen for your child go with them? That's the concept of Family Zone. So it's a, and I'm often told it's like we're trying to boil the ocean. It's a big ambition, but that's what Family Zone's about. It's a policy set that sits in the cloud that can be syndicated, can be used anywhere. So literally, I can register my child, make a decision about whether he can access Facebook or Instagram and for how long he can do that. And I can enforce that decision at school, at home, at McDonald's, in a mobile network, anywhere my child can go on any device in any network, I can enforce that decision. So that's the unique thing about Family Zone. And it opens us up to all sorts of different sorts of collaborations, which is the really exciting things that, that happen in our business.
So Tim, can you tell me a bit more about how you deploy your services? I understand you have a box set up, a home network, and an app. You're used by parents, by schools. Tell us a bit more about the tangible deployment.
Yeah. So look, to launch this big idea, we started with what's called over-the-top approaches. So it's a router that you can install into your network at home, and it overlays your home network with a filtered network for your kids. All personalized settings, but there is a filtered network for your kids and an unfiltered network for mum and dad. And then mobile technology can put on your kids' devices, translate that same kind of managed internet experience outside of the home. So anywhere your child goes, you've got technology either in the router or on the mobile device managing your child's activity. Now, I call it as over the top because we had to launch this product into the market to prove to the world, I guess, the providers of connectivity, that there is a space for syndicated policy sets. Now, it's a technical word, but there is a place for cloud-based policy sets that can be enforced on a device or in a router anywhere. So our vision there is that, well, we're trying to encourage telcos and other device manufacturers to preload our technology in their devices down the track, and that's starting to happen as well. But going back to it, so our main consumer focus is these over-the-top products, the Family Zone box, the Family Zone app, and then that allows the parent to manage the internet experience of their kids by and large. Beyond the home, what we also have is a whole suite of cyber safety technology for schools. Filtering technology, firewall technology, classroom tools to put the power in the hands of the teaching staff so they can control what the kids can access. They can open up browsers. They can literally have complete control in the classroom. What's unique, because we're a cloud-based ecosystem, the same platform that's operating in the class is the one that's operating at home. And so it means that the policy settings can be shared between the two organizations. So the school can be responsible for the kid's internet activity, be the kid at McDonald's or on the 3G networks or 4G network or in class. The school can be responsible between 8:30 in the morning and 3:15, but at 3:16, all power is transferred back to the family. And the parents can turn disable parental controls, or they can enable parental controls. It's their choice. So Family Zones, because this unique technology we've got, we allow a collaboration between schools and parents and give the power and the choice that these parties have never had before.
And the other collaborations you touched on earlier are between Family Zone and the telcos. I know you just announced a big deal with Vodafone. What can you tell me about this partnership approach?
Yeah, look, that's really exciting. And that's the origins of the idea, actually, is how do we get the connectivity providers, be it telcos or device manufacturers, to embrace this ecosystem? Now, a lot of them already have parental controls. Telcos have filtering sometimes in their mobile networks and very poorly taken up. You know, globally, parental controls, in fact, are less than 4% of parents globally use parental controls. So take up in telco filtered products is very low. Take up of parental control settings in smart devices and routers, again, is very low. And we think one of the weaknesses in them is they're isolated. You know, having a filter on a mobile service is kind of redundant if the kid can hop onto Wi-Fi and not be filtered. So what's the point of it? By embracing our ecosystem, it means a telco can say, well, I can filter you in the mobile network and I can have those same policy settings working everywhere else your child would go. And yeah, so that deal with Vodafone is really significant. Vodafone globally has evaluated us against other products and selected us to be rolled out in India as the first trial. And you know, as in conjunction with that launch, we're preloading our software on devices in India from a massive Android manufacturer called Micromax. You may not have heard of them, but believe me, they're huge. And yeah, so straight out of the factory, these devices will be preloaded with Family Zone, promoted by Vodafone, and it's the perfect expression of what we can do. You know, it means that we can allow parents to very seamlessly and easily adopt parental controls. It means those same devices can be managed according to school settings during school time, and it offers an opportunity for revenue share with the carriers, right? Allowing the carriers to monetize their relationship. It's the perfect expression of what we're trying to do. It's very exciting.
And speaking of devices, I know you're very involved with the FZ1 Android smartphone coming out. What can you tell us about this?
Yeah, look, this is really, really exciting. We describe it as the world's first cyber safe phone. It's a Family Zone branded device, Android device that's launching for Christmas. We've got some big news coming about retailers that will start to range it, but I can't tell you about that at the moment, but big stuff coming. The thing that's interesting about this FZ1 device is that if you go hunting in the internet or in a retail outlet for a child-friendly device, you'll probably find a phone or a watch or something with big buttons, and it'll be like a call mum, you know, that's the sort of kid-friendly devices that are sold in retailers today. And no kid who wants their first mobile phone wants that device. You know, kids who are 8 now are getting their first devices, and they want a fully featured phone. They want iPhones, mostly in Australia, but they want facial recognition, they want social apps, they want games, they want Live 360 location, they want all of that stuff. And so Family Zone, the FZ1, is really the first time a child can get a fully featured device. Anything that you would like on that device, any app, any services provided by Google are available. But there is one rider, and that is that the parent has complete control. Once the parent activates their Family Zone account, the parent is completely in control of that device. So it's very unique. We and a lot of the retailers we're speaking to in Australia in particular and in New Zealand are truly excited about this. Yeah, it's launching for Christmas.
And can you tell me a bit about the pathway to commercialization, how you're going to scale to profitability?
The main way we generate revenue actually is through schools. Our approach with schools is very different. So we go to a school and say, we've got this whole suite of best practice classroom tools and network filtering tools, but we don't really want to charge you for those. What we want to do with you is run cyber safety programs within your community. So if we charge a school, you know, $10,000 a year for all of our technology, we actually give that school 200 parent accounts. We call them family packs. And so we sort of impose ourselves on the school to say, well, let's not just filter in the network. Let's run programs to introduce cyber safety across the entire community. And maybe let's start with the year 4s and 5s where they get the first iPads, and then kind of gradually roll out programs across the school years. We find actually most schools are more aggressive than that. Most schools want to, because of the big challenges in schools about, you know, mobility, devices moving inside and outside the school networks. We're finding most schools are actually saying, well, let's do something more than that. Let's mandate Family Zone for the parent community, or let's maybe get the school to buy some Family Zone packs. And then they start rolling out the programs themselves. And so that's mainly how we do it. So we have a direct fulfillment business where parents can buy online, but most of the people that sign up to Family Zone are either forced to or coerced by, or otherwise it's provided by the schools. And that's doing really well. So that's the big point of difference, the reason why we're doing so well selling into schools. And why parent take-up is incredibly strong. We're getting 24% of parents in these schools using our service. I mean, if you think about that, that's just an amazing recognition of the problem and the value that we bring to these schools.
Well, Tim, it's very interesting stuff, very unique story. Can you sum it up for us, please, with the next key milestones moving forwards that your investors need to stay tuned for?
Well, look, I think the launch of this FZ1 is a really big thing. I think it's going to create market noise, PR opportunities, obviously revenue growth and margin opportunities, and bring subscribers to us. It's a big symbol of the potential of our technology. So I think that's a really big thing. But, fundamentally, what our business is really about is kind of engaging with school communities through our school platforms. In Australia and New Zealand, it's a big sales period. It happens at the end of the year, end of the calendar year. So that's happening now. So I think the market should expect some big sales results for us through the end of the year. And then some of these telco deals. We've got deals with telcos with over 700 million subscribers. And those telcos have been trialing things for the last year, and those will turn into real live deployments in kind of January, February, March next year. So they're kind of three areas: the Family Zone One launch, massive telco opportunities, but the kind of bread and butter business for us is selling through into and through these schools, and that business in particular is doing incredibly well. In fact, I should touch on, our revenue from that channel is doubling every 6 months. So that part of our business is absolutely flying.
Tim, sounds like a really exciting time, and like there's a lot of news coming our way. I do hope you'll tell us all about it as it happens.
Look forward to it. Thank you.